when we walk beneath the redwoods and we see all the beautiful plants that have a relationship with them. And we know that we also have a relationship with them.
We think a lot about our ancestors, our family from before, about the beauty that they lived with. And the redwoods are one of those ecosystems that's traditional in our homeland in the East Bay. In Chochenyo, our word for redwood is sumen, sumen. In the days before colonization, some of our family's villages are immediately located under the redwoods of today, what is the Oakland Hills, the San Leandro Hills right there. So much abundance in such a small space. We know for sure that our ancestors, that they lived with beauty in some of those redwood villages right there. They gather those foods right there that grow under the redwood trees, the chanterelle mushrooms, the redwood sorrel, the yerba buena, and the Indian strawberries, such delicacies that we still enjoy to this day. Once the redwoods of the East Bay Hills were the tallest coast redwoods in the entire world. And we think about how hard it was to see those original redwoods milled and logged, taken down from where they belong. And we also know that those redwoods, that they're resilient. The Casalonis are resilient. Those redwoods, they came back a second time and they were logged again. Those redwoods, they came back a third time, and those are the redwoods that are standing today. One day, those redwoods will grow and they'll be as large as those giants from thousands of years ago. It takes showing them respect and kindness. When we think about how those redwoods are able to regenerate, continue themselves right where they've always been, we think as well about our story right there and how it's connected. You know, those redwoods have a right to exist in our home, just as we Ohlones have a right to exist. There's never been a generation away from the space, and we know there never will be.